Yeah, well, my government name is Max Torres. I was born in DR. I started writing graffiti in 78. My cousin moved down from New York. He brought down a lot of pictures and he was showing me what was being done. I gravitated towards that because there was nothing here. That world didn't exist. And so then after that, I graduated into painting. So we started painting this and that and everything where I can get my hands on, I will paint. Yeah, so music has been part of my life since I can remember, being from Dominican Republic, listening to all the old stuff, you know, all the merengue, stuff like that, which actually one of the songs by Johnny Ventura, El Caballo Negro, it's called El Tabaco Fuerte, Por Aquí Fumarlo. My mom used to play that record to death, and it stuck on me. So when the opportunity came up to do something for the Marlins, for you guys, all these ideas came into play. El tabaco fuerte, para que fumarlo. You see the guy holding the hand right here with the tabaco? You see what I'm saying? Ta-na-na-na. And all the rhythms, the tambor, the maraca, you know, that's all intertwined. And that's what influenced the shirt. For example, even down to the passport, boom, official. If you look inside the passport, like I said, you have to look deep into the passport. Deep into the passport, you'll see the font. And it says Santo Domingo, Santo Domingo, Santo Domingo, Santo Domingo. Across, but it looks like lines, but it's not just lines. So it just goes to show you how all these different influences between things that I've seen when I grew up to the record. You know, Johnny Ventura, El Caballo Negro, you know, doing El Tabaco Fuerte. So all these things are influencing the jersey. And the maracas, the reason why they have a yellow stripe is because they're derivative of Los Diablo Cajuelos. Los Diablo Cajuelos are part of this carnival that we have, just like they have in Brazil and in South America, where they dress up as like devilish looking figures. And they come around and then, you know, they toy around with the kids and stuff like that. And it's part of the festival. And that's pretty much what like inspired the jersey. The jersey is inspired by everything that I can remember when I was in Dominican Republic. The Marlins, just like everything else, it became a cultural phenomenon. It bound people together. It brought people together. The same way hip hop brought people together. It's the same thing. It brought different nationalities. It didn't matter whether you were from Uruguay or from Brazil or from wherever. If you're living in Miami and you're here for a few years, forget it. You become a fan. It doesn't matter who you are, blah, 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 doo-doo-doo, whatever, whatever. It doesn't matter. You're gonna become a Marlins fan.